Good morning.
Well, let's hear, just say your name and tell me your good morning feelings.
My name is Ed. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, everybody.
I happy to go when I woke up today. I said thank you, God, I woke up again another day and live in peace.
Okay, live in peace. Peace is your word, right?
That is right.
Peace, all right.
Good morning, guys. Again, my name is Shelley, and good morning.
Good morning,
thank
Shelley.
You so much for coming today, participating. Again, we are the Bowery Arts Project, a bunch of volunteers who come here twice a week, Wednesdays and Thursdays.
It's been called the fourth floor since 1967. Wow. The real name is a crisis center. It's a place to go when you're in crisis. You don't necessarily have to be in withdrawal or using, if you're about to use, if you're feeling desperate. You can go there and have a little bit of a respite and speak to people and stay there until, you know, we try to find someplace else for you to go.
I'll give a little bit of my love to you. There's so much that we need to share. So send a smile and show you care.
Anything that's going to keep me busy and keep me on the right track, I enjoy doing. And it's something that I'm working on practicing for the rest of my life. I've been fighting with addiction since 98, you know, and I feel this right here shows me being feeling trapped off.
Right.
Into my own little box, my own little world. And I'm fighting a spiritual warfare between good and evil, right or wrong, whichever way you want to put it.
I'm constantly surprised. I'm constantly surprised by the openness. I am surprised by the joy and the pleasure that the men get from doing art projects. I'm surprised by the pleasure and the joy I get from working with them and getting to know people individually and talking. I'm always surprised by how amazing the artwork is. I definitely believe this is a program that should be replicated as many places as possible with different populations. I think it's really valuable.
The guys start to get really involved. They find out that they are very creative, that they have stifled a lot of feelings and emotions, and they become quite expressive when it begins. Once it's explained and Erica starts working with them, the room starts to come to life.
And what it represents for him is the actual, what actually happens to them when they're using drugs and alcohol. It's like a spiritual death. They actually are walking dead, so to speak, with the drugs, the smoking, the alcohol. They feel like they're dying. But then when they come into Project Renewal, right, and we start doing groups and they meet with the counselors and they get that first meal or just even the smile that they get from the staff members on the unit, they start to feel like life is worth living again. They start to build self-esteem and they start to feel like they love themselves. So that it's like a layered process for them. They come in like this, right, but then they leave like this.
And I've seen our guys work through a lot of stuff up here just by sitting and doing some artwork.
And I'm tired of doing wrong, I'm tired of hurting people. You know what I'm saying? I want to give back now. That's what it's about, giving back.
I think that it works for everybody to just be there at a table next to people that they don't know, to be making something, to find the peace that making brings, mm-hmm. and to, I don't know, just exchange, you know, thoughts and tell stories and get to know people for just those few hours of the day.
Yes, my plans is to move on, go on, head on to rehab. I had a year clean. I'm going to rehab and start my life back over, get back on track, and take it one day at a time. What I wrote up here says, love myself, say no to drugs, and yes to life. And that's what I mean today, is yes to life, a new beginning.
Now's the time that we need.
Work it out.